Can all of breast imaging be summarized in 4 easy steps? Yes. Yes, it can. If we are going to break down all the nuances and complexity of breast imaging, the first thing we have to do is make sure we keep it simple. Step 1 of breast imaging is detection, finding an abnormality, usually on a mammogram. There are only 6 possible abnormalities that you are looking for in breast imaging: a mass, calcifications, an asymmetry or focal asymmetry, architectural distortion, an enlarged lymph node, or skin thickening or other changes. Once you have identified a possible abnormality, then you need to determine, is it a real finding? Step 2 is localizing an abnormality. Where is it located? The way that this is typically done is by describing the quadrant that it is within: upper outer, upper inner, lower outer, or lower inner. We also use clock position to be more specific. 2 other descriptors that are sometimes used are subareolar or axilla. Step 3 of breast imaging is characterizing the finding. Is it suspicious or not? The way that we do this is by using prior studies for comparison, using additional mammographic views to sort out the features of the abnormality, using clinical data. Is it palpable or is it causing nipple or skin changes? We also use ultrasound and breast MRI to get additional information regarding the abnormality. And the last step is action. Should the patient return to regular screening because it is normal or benign? Is follow-up required in 6 months or 1 year? Or is the abnormality suspicious and require a biopsy? If it requires a biopsy, the next question is how? Will it be ultrasound guided, stereotactic, or MRI guided? And the last possible action is surgery. This is used infrequently, but is always an option if a suspicious finding is not amenable to percutaneous biopsy. There they are, the 4 simple steps of breast imaging: detection, localization, characterizing, and action.
Thank you for watching. Please click subscribe to see more of our content, or go to MAMMOGUIDE.COM to learn more about breast imaging.